This is Professor Corey, and in this mini-lecture, I will demonstrate a method for determining whether a salt is acidic, basic, or neutral when dissolved in water. The first step in this process is to take the salt and break it into the ions that make up the salt. This is a good time to refresh your memory of polyatomic ions, as a salt can be either a metal in a nonmetal or a compound with a polyatomic ion. The salt given is sodium nitrate. The ions that make this salt are the sodium ion and the nitrate ion. Both of these ions will be analyzed using a hydrolysis reaction. If the anion of a salt is a conjugate base of a strong acid, like the nitrate ion shown, now realize this ion came from the salt, not the strong acid, so maybe the salt was KNO3. A good approach to writing these reactions is to view water as HOH. If the ion is negative, it'll combine with the proton from water, the H+. In this case, we would form the strong acid, HNO3, and this can't happen because strong acids completely ionize. So any strong acid produced would just immediately go back into ions. The effect of this ion on the pH is so small, we can simply call it a neutral ion. Now notice that this ion does not form a strong acid, and we have an equilibrium formed. The presence of the hydroxide ion makes this a basic solution. Again, if we write water as HOH, and since the ion is negative, it'll combine with the positive proton from water, the H, or the H+. Remember, when we look at the salt, we have to consider the cations as well as the anions. The sodium ion will combine with the hydroxide ion from water to form NaOH. And this won't happen because the sodium hydroxide is a strong base, and strong bases will immediately dissociate into ions. This chart shows many ions and categorizes them. You should convince yourself that these are correct by reacting the ion with water and looking for the presence of hydronium ion or the hydroxide ion. The presence of the hydronium ion makes the solution acidic. Likewise, if your reaction forms the hydroxide ion, then the solution will be basic. If a strong acid or base is formed, then the reaction does not take place and the ion is neutral. Here are three salts. See if you can determine if they would be acidic, basic, or neutral when dissolved in water. Pause the video and I'll give a detailed explanation on the next slide. The results are written under each salt. The reaction of water with water is shown for each. Notice in the first example, we formed ammonium hydroxide along with the hydrogen ion. Ammonium hydroxide is one of the compounds that decomposes very quickly to form ammonia in water, so the products for this reaction would be the hydronium ion, ammonia, and water. The presence of the hydronium ion is what makes this an acidic salt. This salt is unique in that one ion is acidic and the other one is basic. And the way we determine if the salt is acidic or basic is to compare the Ka to the Kb. NH4+ has a Ka of 5.6 times 10 to the negative 10. I got this value from the chart in your summary packet. The Kb of the sulfide ion is 1 times 10 to the fifth. The equilibrium expression tells us if the reaction is reactant favored or product favored, so the larger value will have more product. Or in this case, since the Kb is larger than the Ka, the sulfide ion reaction is producing more product than the ammonium ion. So we're producing more OH-, and this salt will be basic. This is the chart from your summary packet with the conjugate pairs and the equilibrium expression values. Make sure you have a copy of this and you're comfortable reading it because you'll be able to use this for your homework and exams. This is a nice practice set that you should try on your own. The answers will be posted on the next slide, so pause the video and try to work through these before advancing. The polyatomic ion for the last salt is the acetate ion. This will react with water to form acetic acid in the hydroxide ion. The presence of the hydroxide ion is what makes this a basic salt. This is our final lecture for acid-base chemistry, where we determined if a salt solution would be acidic, basic, or neutral. Our next chapter is advanced acid-base chemistry, so mastering the concepts from this chapter will be especially useful. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more mini lectures from the Professors DuBois.